Hello guys, I am Flash Isaac, and today I'll be taking you through change of subject formula in mathematics. In mathematics, formulas are facts or rules that uses the mathematical symbol. So formula usually has equality sign and two or more variables. Now, facts or rule, they usually have equality sign and two or more variables. If you say A is equals L times B, where this is area of a rectangle, which is equals length times breadth. So this is a formula for calculating the area of a rectangle. Now, looking at this formula, you notice that it has the equality sign and it has variables L and B. Variables are values that are unknown or the values we need to find. If you say A is equals L times B, that means L and B are variables, they change. The opposite of variable is constant. Numbers like 1, 10, generally in mathematics, are called constants. So in this case, if L is equals 2 and B is equals 1, area is simply L times B, that means 2 times 1 is equals 2. How about we change the length to 3 and the breadth to 2? Area will certainly change. So these are variables and this is an equation. And another thing in mathematics is expression. Expressions don't have the equality sign. If I tell you that u plus at, if I give you this, this is an expression because it doesn't have equality sign. The difference between an equation and expression is the equality sign. Once you have equality sign, then this is an equation because equation says one thing is the same as the other. Now that you know this, what is subject formula? Subject formula is simple. It's a single variable, usually at the left, that every other thing is equal to. Look at it. Area is equals length times breadth. Or better still, area is equals L times B. If you look at this very well, area is a single variable. And length times breadth is on the left side. That means area is equals LB. So this A is the subject formula. Okay, let's say volume. Volume V is equals L times B times H, which is V is equals LBH. Now, this is V here, it's standing on its own, and it's equals everything here, this many stuff. So that means this V is the subject formula. It can also be at the right. I can say LBH is equals V. So this is the same thing as V is equals LBH. You can interchange. So subject of formula is that single subject that every other thing is equal to. If I say V is equals U plus AT, it's an equation. So this is the subject and it's equals every other thing here. So that's what subject formula is about. Now, what is change of subject formula? Change of subject formula is an operation which requires us to change subject of the formula. For example, this in A is equals LB, length times breadth. Area is the subject formula. We may be asked to change the subject to L. We want to make L subject formula. That means we are asked to do everything possible to make sure that this L is standing alone and is equal to every other stuff. So we are separating it from the other variables or values. So in that case, if I have this, I can say, okay, area is equal to length times breadth. Let me divide both sides by B. If I divide here by B, and I divide here by B, B cancels B. This will simply be L is equals A over B. In this case, you see, L is not alone and it's equal to every other thing. So we've been able to make L subject formula. So having this understanding, let me bring one or two questions and we'll change the subject formula to make you understand change of subject formula more. Okay, fine. Take a look at these questions. Number 1 to 10. change of subject formula. Look at it. The first question is that, and we are asked to make U subject formula. And in this question, in this equation, the subject formula already is else. The subject formula here is V. So we are asked to change the subject formula to A. Which one should we start with? Okay, let's start with number 6. Our question 6 says S is equals A plus B. So we are asked to make a subject formula. Now look at it. What is joining these two? Is addition. So if addition or subtraction is joining two values, what you do is collect like terms. But if the multiplication is joining two stuff like this, you can't collect like terms. What you do is divide. So since this is joined by addition, and if it is joined by subtraction also, what you do is you collect like terms. So that's how you deal with addition and subtraction. Therefore, multiplication, you divide. Therefore, subtraction, you multiply. We'll see more of that. So given this, collecting like terms in the sense that, not that they are like, but since we need only this one, that means S and B are like because we don't need them. So what we don't need and what we need. So what we don't need are like. What we need is on its own. So in that case, S, take B to this side. So it will be S minus B remaining A. So A is the subject formula. So we can rearrange this to have A is equals S minus B. So that is the answer. We've made A subject formula. And if you also have something like this, S is equals A over B, and we are asked to make A subject formula. Look at this. The first thing you do in your mind, you know that this is the same thing as over 1. Anything that is standing on this board is divided by 1. You have this. So what you do now is cross multiply. This. So this times this and this times this. S times B will give you S, your BS is equals 1 times A. So therefore, A is equals BS. We've made A subject formula. So this is an interesting topic, right? Cool. So we've solved 6. Now let's see number 5. Number 5 says F is equals MA. And what are we making subject formula? M. So M and A. The distraction here is A. We'll look for what to do to remove this A so that we have only M as the subject. And with this, and they are being joined by multiplication. So I told you when you have multiplication, the first thing that should come to your mind is division. Then when you have addition joining stuff, the first thing that will come to your mind is taking sum to the other side of the equality sign. In this case, I can say over A, this over A, because if A divided by A, it will be 1. M times 1 is M. So this goes, giving you M. So you have F over A is equals M. So rearranging F or turning it, M is equals F over A. So we made M subject formula for this equation. Now similarly, for 4, it says V is equals LBH. And we need L as subject formula. So what to do is this, they are being joined by multiplication and the three of them are together. So we divide by what we don't need. We need L, so we divide by BH. Remember, what happens to this side should happen to this other side. So here will be BH. So this BH divides BH, will be left with L, which is what we need already. So V over BH is equals L. That implies that L is equals V over BH. That is the answer. You see? So let's proceed. A is equals V raised to the power of 3. So this is cube. So the best way to remove cube is to find cube root. What does that imply? So this is A, this is V cube. We don't need V cube. We need V. We don't need V cube or V raised to the power of 3. We need V. So in that case, to remove this raised to the power of 3, you look for the cube root of both sides. So cube root of this would be A is equals cube root of V raised to the power of 3. Now, in my indices class, I explained this. This is because cube root of A, this is equals V raised to the power of 3 cube root is the same thing as 1 over 3. So therefore, this is the same thing as a raised to the power of 1 over 3 is equals v raised to the power of 3, and then raised to the power of 1 over 3. So that's how you convert cube. That's how you remove cube. Because with this now, we can easily say here is the same thing as 1 times 1 over 3. 3 times 1 over 3. So here is 3 times 1 over 3. 3 times 1 is 3 over 3. So this will give you 1. So in that case, we removed cube roots. We now have a 1 over 3 is equals v. So v is equals a raised to the power of 1 over 3, or v is equals cube root of a. So that's how you do that for that. It's pretty simple, right? So we are moving. Let's proceed. Okay, we solve this. What is next? We've solved this. Okay, let's see. Number 9. Number 9 says z is equals a b plus ac. So we are making a subject formula. So if you take a look at this, we have a here, we have a here, but we need one. We don't need two a's, we need just one a. So what do we do in this case? Let's see. We'll come and say z is equals, there's a here, there's a here, so now there's addition holding them. So we can't take one out because we certainly need the two a's. So we need to do something that will leave us with one a, and it will not be manipulation. So looking at this, I can say, okay, factorize, something called factorization. You can check my video on that also, Flash Learners YouTube channel or flashlearners.com. So a, now you do bracket, a b divided by a will give you what? B, because a will cancel a, giving you b, plus a c divided by a c over a. This will cancel this to remain c, so here will remain c. So we factorized. So that is the basis to factorization. Now having this, we need a, but we don't need this. We don't need here. We don't need here. So what we do is pretty simple. We take what we don't need away. So since this is together, this is everything here is together in bracket, we can simply divide here by b plus c and divide here by b plus c. So in that case, since this cancels this, we will leave us with a. So that means z over b plus c is equals a, and a is equals z over b plus c. So that is that. We made a subject formula. Pretty sure, right? Interesting. So let's see next. Okay, so we've solved this. 2 here. Okay, 3. Okay, let's see number 3. Number 3 says h is equals half gt square, and we need t. So given this is the same thing as h is equals gt square over 2. Now having this, like I did earlier, this is the same thing as over 1. So if we cross multiply means multiply here by this, multiply here by this. H times 2 will give you 2H. 2H is equals 1 times GT square is equals GT square. Okay, we started one stage. Now what else? We need only T and not T square. But the square is not the only thing. It's not the only barrier to our solution. There's g again, so we totally don't need this. So we need to start from somewhere, start removing the things we don't need gradually, in their order of unimportance. Yes, we start from the least important. Because if you are starting from here, it may affect the process. So this next, 2h is equals gt square. So if you divide here by g, and also divide this side by g, g cancels this. So we have 2h over g is equals t square. Now, t is important, t square is 2t, which is important, but that's not what we need. So that is the next body now. We need to remove it. It's the next important thing we have to remove to get to the promised land. Okay? So we now observe this question. Observing, we know that to remove square with square root both side, to remove cube with cube root both side, wisdom. In that case, we are looking for the square root of 2h over g is equals, then we square root this side also, t square. Remember that square root is the same thing as 1 raised to the power 1 over 2. So this implies that this is the same thing as 2h over g is equals t square, the raised to the power 1 over 2. That's what square root is about. So this will cancel. 2 times half is 1. 2 times 1 over 2 is 1. So this goes. So we now have square root of 2h over g is equals t. So in that case, t is equals root 2h over g. So it's making sense, right? So that's how it is. So in most exams, you won't have very complex questions. So all these questions are there. So if you understand all the operations so far, even if the question is complex, you'll be able to solve it. Yes. So you can see all these questions you are seeing, they look big. And this also looks big. So by the time we start solving them and applying the rule and tricks we've been using for other questions, you'll see that it's just the size, not the process. Cool? So, let's see. So with this, we can just say V minus U is equals AT because they are being joined by addition. So we can remove one. But this A and T are being joined by multiplication. So you can't just remove T and bring this way. We have to divide. So that is the procedure for multiplication. So to remove this, we divide here by T. We divide here by T. So this T cancels T. We're now left with V minus U over T is equals A. So this is the same thing as A is equals V minus U over T. So acceleration is change in velocity over time. Physics students can relate. So that's that. We solved this. Now, number one says we should make U subject formula. So if you are making U subject formula, given S is equals UT plus half AT square, and we're making U subject formula. So I can simply say S minus half AT square is equals UT. Yeah. So this is addition is holding them. So we can just take this and bring this way. So when you take addition to the other side of the quantity sign, it becomes subtraction. So this is this. And what is holding this two is multiplication, that is U times T. We need just U. So to remove T and get our U as subject formula, we divide both sides by T. This is T and this is T. T cancels T. So S minus 1 over 2 AT square is equals U over T. So U is equals S minus half AT square over T. It's making a lot of sense, right? It's making sense. So if as sweet as it is so far, you still don't understand, you can ask me a question. I will answer you. Good girl. Okay. We are left with the two big guys. Two big guys. This says we should look for arrow. And this says we should look for T. Okay, let me start with question 8. 8 says P is equals Q arrow minus T over 15, 1 over 3. Make T subject formula. So given this question, then we start removing, start doing stuff gradually until we clear the air, we remove every other unnecessary stuff and get to the root of the matter. If I'm starting this, the biggest barrier now is this raised to the power of 1 over 3 because it's covering everything. So we can't touch it without removing that. And remember what I told you earlier. I said to remove cube. That means S something raised to the power of 3. You look for cube root. Now, to remove cube root, you cube the expression. So it's vice versa. If you are given cube, then you do cube root of both sides to remove the cube. Then if you are given cube root, you do cube of both sides to remove the cube root. Look at what I'm saying. This equation is the same thing as Q arrow minus T over 15 here, cube root. So anything raised to the power of 1 over 3 is the same thing as cube root. So this is cube root of this. Now what do we do? Let's look for the cube of both sides. Now cube means raised to the power. Let's explain between cube and cube root. Cube means raised to the power of 3. Cube root is raised to the power of 1 over 3. Or this. Hope it's cool. So fine. So if I look for the cube of both sides, I'll say okay, p raised to the power of 3, the cube of this, is equals this whole stuff raised to the power of 3. So this will be the same thing as everything here raised to the power of 3. So this cube, we cancel the cube root. So it's something like this. If this is the same thing as raised to the power of 1 over 3, then you now cubed it. So this will give you 1 over 3 times 3. So this will cancel this to remain the equation on its own. And the equation will still be correct because what happened to this side has also happened to this other side. So we are now left with p raised to the power of 3 is equals q arrow minus t over 15. So it's making sense, right? So the next thing I will do is cross multiply. This is the same thing as over 1. So this. So I'll say 15 times p raised to the power of 3 is 15 p raised to the power of 3 is equals q arrow minus t. So the next thing I'll do, because we are removing the distraction, the barriers gradually, this is the next threat. So we have to eliminate it. So, and what is separating the threat and this bracket is multiplication. This implies that we are dividing both sides by q. So if I divide here by q, and I divide here by q, this will cancel this. So 15 p raised to the power of 3 over q will be equals arrow minus t. You notice that life has been made easier, right? So we are gradually getting to the root of the matter. So what I will do in this case is, what is holding these two guys is subtraction. I'll take t this way and move these other guys that way. In that case, t is crossing the equality sign with negative sign to become positive, and equals arrow is remaining, and this is crossing with positive sign to become negative, minus 15 p to the power 3 over q. So that is it. We made t subject formula. Hope you enjoyed this. Good. Okay. So we have arrow here. We have arrow here. We are asked to make arrow subject formula. That means we are looking for single arrow. So what do we do? So we are no longer new to the game. We know a lot of rules. To remove square root, we square both sides. So that means p square is equals q arrow. Yes, you are no longer a baby, you are now big. So you are learning speed. And that's how you should do on your own. You start learning with getting slow, but with time, you need to improve your speed. You already know what to do. So from here, we know that to remove this square root, we square both sides. So we've squared this. The square here, I've removed the square root, so it's left with this. And we divide p square over q is equals r 1 plus 3t over r. Notice, right? What did we do? We divided both sides by q. So q cancels here, q comes here. So we are left with this. Cool? So we are solving it on your own and see if you have to arrive at this. Okay, don't worry. If you are scared, I won't do shortcut again. I won't jump. I'll do everything step by step. But on your own, learn to improve your speed, especially for objective exams. Okay, so we have this. I will say, okay, P square over Q is equals, I open the bracket, arrow times one is arrow plus arrow times this, everything here will be arrow 3t over arrow. So I think life has been made easy here. Arrow, arrow. So that means this arrow will cancel this arrow. So therefore, P square over Q is equals arrow plus 3t. Because arrow has divided R. So the barrier here is now 3t. And addition is holding them. So that means we can move it to this side. P square over Q minus 3t is equals R. Therefore, R is equals P square over Q minus 3t. So we made R subject formula. How sweet it is. How sweet it is. Thank you. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel to get more updates.